A very good evening to all of you. This is Rajiv and welcome back. And today we will talk about the Morph Transition in Microsoft PowerPoint 2016 or 2019. So let's get started without wasting any time. So here in this presentation, I am using 9 different slides and each slide have 2 objects, one rectangle and one oval. And if you move to the 6th slide, then you can see that the rectangle has changed to a triangle. And this is just to clarify you a few things about the Morph Transition. So we will start from the first slide, and you can see that I have not applied any transition on the first slide. So it is advisable not to use Morph Transition on the very first slide because it will not make any sense. So if I show you that if I apply the Morph Transition and the default duration of the Morph Transition is 2 seconds, you must note down these two things, that the default duration is 2 seconds for Morph Transition and you shouldn't apply the Morph Transition on the very first slide. So as I have applied this transition, so if I show you the slideshow, then it will not make any sense. You will just see a fading effect during the slideshow. So now we will talk about the Morph duration that I have applied on this presentation. So if you look at the transition timing of Morph, then you will find that I have applied the same duration on all the slides for the Morph Transition. But there is a difference between the advanced slide. So here on the first slide, I am advancing to the next slide in 1 second. However, the duration of the transition is 2 seconds. You must note down these two things, that the duration is 2 seconds, but I am advancing to next slide within 1 second. So how it will work? So on the second slide, the advancing to next slide is 3 seconds. And then rest of the slide has the same duration of advancing to next slide to 1 second. So let me tell you the behavior of Morph Transition. As you can see that on our first slide, this rectangle and oval is on the left side. And on the very second slide, I just move these objects by selecting and dragging them to this position. However, I also change the position of the oval. As you can see on the first slide, the oval is on the right. But on the second slide, the oval is on the left side. As it is a grouped object, as you can see, I have selected this object and it selected both of these objects. And if you go to the shape format and click the group drop down button, then you can find that group and regroup is disabled and ungroup is working. So that means this object is grouped. So in grouped objects, if you want to select an object within from a group, then you can just simply click on that particular object within a group and it will get selected. Now if you will move that object, then it will affect on that particular object only within from a group. So as both of these shapes are grouped together and I just change the position of this oval, so let me set it to none for the first slide. As I told you that there will no benefit of setting it to Morph. And on the second slide, as you can see that I have applied the Morph Transition with the duration of 2 seconds. And the advancing to next slide is 3 seconds. So how it is going to behave? So if I see the slideshow, then you can notice the movement between the first and second slide. Let me show you once again. The shapes are moving to right, but the oval just fade out and then fade in. So that is not what we want. So I will advise you not to use grouped objects and do not change their position if you are going to use the Morph Transition. So that is why I have created these first 2 slides. On the first slide, we have a grouped object, and on the second slide, I am moving that grouped object to the right and also moving a particular object to the left within from a group. And that is how it will show you the effect. So now we will talk about the third slide. So on the second slide, you can see that the advance to next slide duration is 3 seconds. And on the third slide, it is 1 second and Morph Transition is same for all the slides. On the third slide, the same rectangle and oval has been moved to the left, but this time I ungrouped them. I duplicated the second slide and on the third slide, I moved them to left and ungrouped them. Now we will see the duration timing, how it will work from second to the third slide and how the ungrouped object will look like during the Morph Transition. So if I show you the slideshow, so during the slideshow, it will stop for 3 further seconds after the Morph Transition. So as you can see that on the second slide, the Morph Transition duration is 2 seconds and the advancing to next slide is 3 seconds. So that is how it works. first the morph transition will end, then it will wait for 3 more seconds, and then it will advance to the third slide. So let me show you it from the second slide again. So after 5 seconds, it will move like this. So that is why I was telling you that you shouldn't use the grouped object. So as we have ungrouped object on the third slide, and then I duplicated the same slide and moved those objects to the right. Now we will see the slideshow from the third slide to fourth slide, and that is what you might need. So that is how the morph transition actually works. Now we will advance to the fifth slide and we will see the difference. So here on the fifth slide, if I open the animation pan, then you can see that I have also applied a spin animation to the rectangle, and the duration of this spin animation is 2 seconds, and the transition timing is 2 seconds, and advancing to next slide within 1 second. So if I move to fourth slide and show you the slideshow, so I have created a slide just to show you that after the morph transition, the animation effect will work. So the animation effects work after the morph transition. So as the morph transition has duration of 2 seconds, so when the transition will end, then the animation's effect will start working. So from the fourth to fifth slide, it will take 2 seconds, and then the spin animation will happen. So let me show you the slideshow again. It is moving from fourth to fifth slide, and it will stop, and then the spin effect will work. So you should note down that also. Now we will talk about the sixth slide. On the sixth slide, what I did, I just changed this rectangle to a triangle by removing one of its points. And how you can do that? You can do that by drawing a rectangle here, and then go to the shape format, click edit shape, and then choose edit points. And if you want to remove that point, you can do that just by right clicking on it and choose delete point. So that is what I did on the sixth slide. I moved the shapes to the right and then just change the shape of the rectangle by deleting one of the points. So how it will look like during the morph transition, let me show you the preview. So after the spin effect, it will move to the sixth slide, and that is how it will show you the change shape. So you can't change the shape during the morph transition, so that is also not going to help you. So you should also note down that you can't use edit shape point if you are using the morph transition. Now we will advance to the seventh slide, and let me check the duration and timings. They are same. So on the seventh slide, what I did, I moved the same object to the left, but this time also changed the oval to a face. And how I did this, you can do that by selecting an object, then go to shape format, and then click edit shape, change shape, and then you can use any shape you want. That way it will change the previous shape exactly to the same size. So now if I advance to the next slide from 6 to 7, then you can notice the behavior of morph transition on change shape. So that is also not going to help. If you are going to use change shape command with the morph transition, then it will also not going to help you. So on the 8th slide, what I did, I move the object to the right, but this time I send the face to the back using the send to back command. So let's see how it will show during the slideshow using the morph transition. So that is also not going to help. If you are moving objects to the front or back and also using the morph transition, then they are not going to look nice during the slideshow. So you should also keep that in the mind. So we have now last slide, ninth slide. So on the ninth slide, we are changing the color of the rectangle and also the outline. And now we will see that how it will work during the slideshow. And you can also note down that the spin effect has been applied on the rectangle, and the duration of this spin effect is, duration of this spin effect is 2 seconds. And we are advancing to next slide after 1 second of morph transition. That means it will take total 3 seconds, but the spin animation has 2 seconds. So we will also see that will it stop the animation or continue to show the spin animation. So let's go to the 8th slide and see the slideshow. Okay. So it ends the slide after the animation. So if I increase the duration of this animation to 4 seconds, and let's see the slideshow from the 8th slide. So both of the objects will move to the left. We'll change the fill color and outline. Now the spin effect will take 4 seconds, and after that the slide will end. So if you are using transition timings and the advancing to next slide, and also using the animations, then it will advance to the next slide after the animation ends. So these were the things that I wanted to discuss with you about the morph transition. As I was working on my next project where I was using the morph transition, then I find out all these drawbacks the morph transition has. And I hope Microsoft will take care of these things. Maybe I could be wrong, but if they change the behavior of morph transition, especially in grouped object, then it could be much better. So I hope you will find this video useful. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to my channel for more upcoming tutorials. Thanks for watching and have a great day.